Hey everyone, Grant here for the Flame Learning channel. In the previous video, we went through the visual improvements to the Action Gmask and Gmask Tracer node in the Flame 2018.1 update. This allows you to set the colors of your Gmask icons, as well as control what you see when working with multiple Gmask shapes. In this video, we'll continue with the Gmask improvements and focus on the selection enhancements that affects the Gmask splines and to some degree extended by Cubic's vertices as well. If you would like to follow along, please refer to the first video on Gmask enhancements and follow the instructions to import the media as well as load the batch group. Starting in action, you have a setup that contains a surface with a few Gmask shapes and a few other hidden objects. Please note that I have no objects currently selected. If you have any objects selected in the action schematic or result viewport, just tap in the gray area of the action schematic to deselect all the objects. Now, one of the first changes when it comes to Gmask selection is that you no longer have to select a layer before selecting its connected Gmask shape. In the Flame 2018.1 update, you simply click on the spline to select it. This basic enhancement will reduce your button clicks from 2 to 1. So selecting and working with individual splines will be slightly sped up. Now, when performing rotoscoping tasks, there is always a great chance that components will overlap. You could have Gmask splines overlapping each other, vertices sitting on top of other vertices, or even vertices sitting on top of an axis. These situations could cause issues with selection. In other words, how would Flame know what to select when you're clicking on two objects that occupy the same position? So a couple of rules have been put in place to make selection easier in these scenarios. Zoom into the image and look at this Gmask shape. Here we have a situation where a Gmask vertex and an object axis occupy the same position in the viewport. In previous versions of the Flame products, if you clicked on that point, there was always the chance of selecting the axis instead of the vertex when trying to do roto work. The new rule states that whenever an axis and vertex overlap, the vertex will always be selected and not the axis. Click on that point and drag the cursor. Straight away, the vertex is selected and you can edit the Gmask spline. So if you're manipulating the vertices of a Gmask, any other icons overlapping or intersecting should not get in the way of the Gmask shape. The second rule deals with selected versus unselected. For example, pan the viewport over to these Gmask shapes. This time, you have two Gmask shapes overlapping each other. So which one has preference over the other? Well, the second rule states that the current selection always wins. In other words, if you select one of the Gmask shapes and start manipulating it, when it comes to any overlapping vertices, Flame will only select the vertex from the current selection. So there is little chance of you accidentally selecting another Gmask shape when clicking the vertex on an overlap. If you want to select the vertex of the alternative Gmask shape, you need to change the focus of the selection to the alternative Gmask spline. Just deselect the current Gmask selection and then select the alternate Gmask shape to be manipulated. Only then will you be able to select its vertex in the overlapping area and move it around. As an extra bonus, the current selection rule is also applied to extended bicubic surfaces. For example, go to the action schematic, hold Ctrl, and draw a box selection around the hidden axis and image surface. Press H to unhide the objects. Looking in the viewport, here you have an extended bicubic surface that is slightly reshaping his face. If you focus on the bicubic edge, to the left of his nose, you can see there is a vertex from the surface overlapping with a vertex from the Gmask shape. There is already vertex animation in both objects, so turn on Auto Key, otherwise any changes you make may just snap back to the animated curve. Once again, applying the second rule, the current selection will have preference with any overlaps. So select the extended bicubic surface. When you click and move the vertex, only the vertex of the selected extended bicubic surface will move. The vertex of the unselected Gmask shape will stay in its place. Press Ctrl Z to undo the vertex move. Now let's do it the other way round. Deselect the extended bicubic surface and select the Gmask shape. When you click and drag the overlapping vertex again, you will note that it is the vertex from the Gmask shape that is moving and not the vertex from the extended bicubic surface. This is all based on the current selection. So as a reminder, firstly, you can now select Gmask shapes without selecting their parent objects. Secondly, the Gmask vertex will always get selected when overlapping with other object icons. Finally, the current selection always wins when it comes to overlapping vertices. Hopefully these rules, in combination with the new visual improvements, will give you a much better masking experience. Be sure to check out the video on Gmask display preferences, as well as the other updates to the Flame 2018.1 update. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel for future videos.